He's a weekend warrior. You know, the number one. The number one weekend warrior right here, week in, week out, on our forum for independent sports on the mat, Nicholas H.
That's right.
I
am here again, I'm telling you, and what can I say? We've got nothing but classic independent wrestling tonight.
Hey. Yes, we do.
We got a full card.
Okay, so hold on a minute here. Let's call it like we see it. So that means you've delved back into your enormous archives, and
that's
you've
right.
pulled us some real winners.
That's right. I tell you what, our first match is in 03, our second match is in 07, and the main event all the way from 01.
01.
01.
2001, that's like 8 years ago.
That's right.
It's a long time back.
I'm telling you.
So, Nicholas H., while I got you here tonight, I had a couple questions for you. Because I ask this to everybody, do I not? Why did Nicholas H., a young little Nicholas H. in the trailer park, what made you grasp, I want to be a pro wrestler, I want to be a referee, I want to be a wrestling manager? What did it for you? What tripped your trigger, Nick?
Well, I tell you, it's kind of funny to where I just turned around and I used to go every Tuesday night with my dad out there.
This is a good story. I remember. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Oh, every Tuesday night, my dad and I used to go to the Riverside Centroplex in Baton Rouge or down in Little Ronger or Hammond and see guys like Colonel Buck Robley III, Bruiser Bob Sweetan, Grizzly Smith, them guys.
Dude, and you grew up in the Deep South.
That's right, man.
Wow,
it was awesome.
That's cool.
And just more or less, I loved it so much, and it was a good time for my dad and I to always kind of hang out with each other. And
really?
I never thought that I could be a wrestler, so that's why I said, all right, I'll try the referee thing. Because
yeah.
I knew that the referee is a very important part of making a match work.
That's a fact.
And
the unsung heroes of pro wrestling.
Yeah, absolutely. And like I said, it was just good times with my dad every Tuesday night. We always used to stop at the Krispy Kreme after the matches, especially in Baton Rouge there.
Yeah.
And just my dad would have his coffee, and I'd have my milk and donut, you know, and we'd just hang out, man.
So then when did it come about that you had to bring your half-brother, Trevor Blanchard, into the mix and start going to the matches with him and your father?
No.
Was there sibling rivalry?
No. There was no sibling rivalry. Granted,
Admit Trevor Blanchard is your long-lost half-brother.
You got me on the spot.
Trevor Blanchard, you're not on the show anymore, but you live within us.
Yes, you do.
Yeah, how about that?
We'll be seeing him soon.
No,
so.
But you grew up watching some really cool wrestling that we didn't see around here. We grew up, it was all AWA. You get a little bit of Texas wrestling. We got world class because of cable TV. But growing up in this area, we basically got a lot of Chicago wrestling, which was cool, but you only heard about this other stuff like Florida and what went on with Lawler and in Memphis and all that stuff. So how close were you to Memphis?
Well, we were closer to Dallas with world class.
Wow.
And if I could have, I'm telling you, as I see it now, if I could have had a car that was dependable enough, I would have gone to Dallas because it was on my mind to be a referee or get into the business somehow. So
well, you did it, Nicholas H. And you're, as far as I'm concerned, you're a success story. And we've been rolling here at On the Mat for quite some time, bringing independent sports every week in, week out. New stuff, fresh stuff, classic stuff, you name it, right here. Our forum for independent sports, OTM. We love to come here week in and week out. We got a big one for you tonight.
That's
the
right.
Void Effect, AM Vision, and Zero taking on Exxplicit Content featuring Bailey Mannix and Delicious Danny Scott.
That's right. And this is a promotion that is no longer around. They turned around and ran a few shows in the summer. And what can I say?
Shop Championship Wrestling.
That's right.
Let's go to that match.
That's right. To the match we go.
Woo!
There we go.
Look at this. Wow, look at this daytime match.
That's right. And it was at the Scoop of the Loop show. I mean, it was a big car show, carnival.
Who's that referee?
Oh, that's the one and only Nicholas H. when I was dyeing my hair blonde.
Wow, look at that. Who videotaped this?
Actually, it was Rosemary Duman. Taped this.
Mom.
That's right.
She did a great job. Look at that. Really, really good. Bright. Are you at an outdoor school?
This was just out in the middle of the street. They had certain streets blocked off, and what can I say? They just turned around and you know, put on one heck of a show.
Looks like a great festival, well attended. Yes. And this is from what year again, Nick?
This was from 2003, Shock Championship Wrestling.
2003. So this is one, oh, here we go. What are we doing here? But this is some action while we're talking about the while we're talking about the match here. The 2003. Now Void Effect, were they cheating on Windy City, working at other promotions when they weren't supposed to be at this time, or were they free and clear?
I think they were free and clear, but I do know the story that this was the opening match of this show, and reason being is because Danny Scott and Bailey Mannix had another shot with Brian Zena with MCW. So they had to do this match, and then they turned around and took off to Rockford or somewhere to do a show for Zener.
Huh, about that. Delicious Danny Scott, I should say.
Getting whipped
off. I have a hard time dealing with a man called Delicious, and I want to call him Dangerous. Matter of fact, for the rest of the telecast, I think I will. Dangerous Danny Scott just really getting it taken to him by the Void Effect. Oh, my gosh, look at this leg drop by AM Vision. Now Zero in there with the pin. Doesn't quite get it, but Danny Scott looks like he's a little worse for wear. Nicholson.
Yeah, well, and also, too, as you wrestling fans do remember, that Danny Scott was the founder and the promoter of Midwestern States Championship Wrestling with Steve Stone and Mike Horning and all them guys out there in Coal City.
Well, you know about all these wrestling promotions, Nicholas H., because you've worked for them all, you've videotaped for them all. Tell me a little bit about Shock Championship Wrestling.
Shock Championship Wrestling only ran for about four or five shows.
Really?
In the Waukegan area.
Looks like good stuff, too.
Yes, they had a real good thing going. But, you know, of course, you know, one thing leads to another, and promoter holding out on his partners and stuff like that. So the next thing I know is that they had a few shows booked with likes of Jason Dukes and Crew Jones and Cole Cabana. Matter of fact, one of their last shows, they had Raven.
Really? He's back on TNA now.
That's right. Mm-hmm. You know, so, I mean, they ran very brief time that they were, in operations. You know, very brief time, but they seem like they have their thing together, but I guess somebody wasn't working well with the other partners, you know, so what do you say? You figure Danny Scott there has got, you know, it looks like he's got a chokehold on one of the Void Effects there.
Gone but not forgotten, Shock Championship Wrestling fans, brought to you right here tonight on our Forum for Independent Wrestling on the Mat. There's Delicious. Yes, his back of his tights say he's Delicious, Danny Scott. Got AM Vision in there, winds up, clocks him right in the side of the face. AM Vision with one of his own, trading punches. Nicholas H. trying to keep some sort of semblance of order. Oh, my goodness, drops him right on the back of the head and neck.
I tell you, it was hot that day. It was definitely hot out there that day. I mean, it was, I kept a cooler of water under the ring because I was roughing that whole show, and the main event for this show, as a matter of fact, was Lethal Lee taking on Cameron Cage. That was the main event.
Wow.
Right, and Lethal Lee is done with the business, and Cameron Cage is working out in the Midwest here and there. So
is he now?
Yeah. I mean, he's more around the St. Louis, Kentucky area.
Is he really? Former Windy City Tag Team Champion, as managed by yours truly.
That's
now,
right.
Is this beautiful downtown Waukegan here?
Yes, it is. He says they shut down a few streets, and they had a huge car show going on, which, I mean, the women were just as hot as the cars.
Wow.
I'm telling you, it was a great time.
Yeah, looking like having a cool car and a hot-looking honey.
You know it, man.
That's the way to go.
You see Bailey Mannix turning around with that chin lock, stretching that neck back.
Bailey Mannix, I will tell you, this guy is, now I'm going to say he's a wily veteran. He's been in the Ring Wars for quite some time.
Right.
And for his size, he's not that big of a guy, but I'm telling you, he's put on a lot of meat on his bones over the past few years. He's in very good shape, and you just can't knock his ring acumen. The guy has just really got it all together. And he's been giving Steve Boz a run for his money over at WCPW.
Matter of fact, Bailey Mannix did turn around and was booked on that big card from Windy City at Toyota Park. He was on the card. You know, he worked a little bit. So
did he?
Yes, he did. He was in the Pot of Gold Battle Royal.
Oh, okay. I heard about that.
Where it was a surprise on who walked out with all the titles that night.
Really?
Yes. All I can say is it was a very big shock. And this gentleman has been a staple in Windy City Pro Wrestling as far as I could remember. And I've been around the business for 10 years now. And this gentleman definitely, he likes to swing that cane If you like that kendo stick, he likes to swing that kendo stick around. And needless to say, he walked out of that pot of gold battle royal with all the major titles in Windy City.
Did he really?
Yes, he did.
Wow, that's a big payday for
you know who.
I can imagine. And you know, when this is all said and done, I think I'm going to go out in the parking lot here and have a psychotic reaction. But enough on that. Look at this match here. Wait a minute. Nicholas H trying to pull out the void effect. Now Bailey Mannix in there with, it looks like, some kind of a chokehold.
That's right. And I'm asking Bailey if they made a tag, which I didn't see, and they're swearing up and
down. So you're asking him like he's going to tell you the truth.
Yeah, well, you never know. I mean, I've got to do my job.
By asking a heel, a villain, if he made the tag or not. What do you think he's going to tell you, Nicholas H?
Well, I figure you never know. And now Bailey Mannix likes to get up there on the top rope. Misses with a big frog splash.
Yes, he did.
These fans definitely getting into it.
Yeah, there's nothing like a festival show. I always have a ball with those. Nicholas H. counting both men down. Bailey Mannix rising to his feet. AM Vision trying to get up there too. Makes the tag, does AM Vision. In comes Zero, House of Fire. Clocks him, down goes Mannix. Down goes Scott with a clothesline. Bam! Taking care of business is the Void Effect. Now Zero and AM Vision in there.
That's right. Now, as you know, AM Vision and Zero, they're doing their tag teaming over there in Underground Wrestling in Joliet.
Are they now?
Yes, they are.
You know, and that's that would be Tony Scarpone.
That's right.
I remember Scarpone. That's a tough dude. Yeah. Uncle, wait a minute. It's busting out now into a fist fight. A Downeybrook into the corner. All four combatants in the ring at once. And look, the Michelin Tire Boy's in attendance.
That's right. Isn't that something else?
Now, he's a big fan.
Yes, he gets my drink. Can you just imagine if you could sign him up as a wrestler?
There you go. That'd be a big dude. Hey, don't give Vince McMahon any ideas.
Yeah, right.
Great Khali in a suit. Here we go. Look at this. The punishment of AM Vision.
It's not going to have hair taped all over, pasted over.
Airbrushed like even.
Yeah, right.
The abs, Giant remember? Gonzalez. Yeah, he had quite some abs airbrushed on his front bodice, he did. Oh, look at this, man. Danny Scott got AM Vision in a bad. Oh, my goodness. Both of these guys involved with this? They're going to break his neck. Oh, my goodness. Assisted pile driver, reverse pile driver. Down he goes. Wait a minute. In to interrupt.
Right, he didn't make the pin. As I know here is that it started to get out of control a little bit, and it looks like
Nicholas H. You're walking to the outside when isn't the match going on inside the ring?
Right, and I'm trying to gain control and so forth.
Oh, look at this! Wait a minute, there's a pinfall in the ring. Look at this, he's got the tights. Wait a minute, reversal. AM Vision. Nicholas H. Quicker than a hiccup in for the one, the two.
And a three.
And a three. Oh, my goodness. That was quicker than a hiccup. Thank goodness we called the finish.
Yeah, that's right.
You get in trouble for that in WWE.
Oh, you
well, that's why we're not there. Yeah.
No, I don't think we'd be able to last that long in WWE.
No?
No.
No, well.
No.
But
I mean,
in WWE, they have cameras where when you're talking to your camera, the light goes on so you know which camera to talk to.
Yeah. Well, you know, I mean, there's Aurora Studios out here in the lovely Aurora off the Fox River. And
beautiful town.
Yeah, maybe we'll get Chris, the playback guy, to fix these lights or something.
Yeah, we'll talk to him.
We'll do that. You know,
sorry, Nick, I didn't mean to.
That's all right. I mean, this is public access at its best. You know, what can I say?
Oh, my goodness, we're here in the land of Bill and Ted, or is it? No, I'm thinking of the other guys.
That's Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Yeah.
No, the other two pimply kids.
I don't know.
Wayne's World, Party Time, Excellent.
Yeah.
This is where they did this show. This actual studio is where they did Party Time, Excellent.
Yes, they did. Yeah. It was something else.
So Nicholas H., maybe next week you'll wear like a Dana Carvey wig.
Can I?
Yeah, you could.
Oh, that'd be great,
you'd look,
man.
You'd look cute like that. You'd be just freaking adorable. Yeah.
Well, I tell you, Richard T.,
yes,
you know,
sir. Oh, we got another match coming up, don't we?
Yes, that we do. But I tell you, all I can say is Toyota Park, when Windy City, you stay at WindyCityProWrestling.com. There will be a video highlight montage. Of what went on at the show. And I'm telling you, fans, for the Hulk Hogan Appreciation Day, it was great. Tito Santana, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, Greg the Hammer Valentine, the Nasty Boys, Jimmy Hart, Lacey Von Erich, Austin Aries, Steve Boz, Austin Roberts, Sean Mulligan.
Wow.
I mean, you're talking about a card that was stacked from top to bottom. And this is why Windy City is the grandfather of all promotions in the Chicagoland area. 20 years strong, and they turn around and pull something like this off, Richard T. It was awesome.
And you were there, Nick.
Yes. I will go out and say I am very much appreciative for being booked on the show as a referee.
Right.
And anytime I have a chance to work with Windy City, I always look forward to working with a great bunch of people, especially Sam DeCero.
Well, no. If I may interject something, Nicholas H., you can thank me for that, and I'll keep making my phone calls to Sam DeCero for you, no problem at all, okay?
Yeah, even though he says, who are you again? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, Nick, yeah.
And you can give me that cut of your payday after the show.
Okay.
All right, don't forget about that.
I can write you a check just like Sam wrote me a check, right?
That's right.
I don't have to sign a check, though.
No.
Okay.
Wait, what a minute. I'm gonna hope so. No, I want cash.
Oh, man. But you know what, fans, real quick, speaking about Sam DeCero, the founder of Windy City, I have dug up from the classic wrestling from St. Louis, where it was the one and only Sam DeCero in his wrestling days taking on the legendary Dick Murdoch.
Sam DeCero wrestling Dick Murdoch.
Sam DeCero wrestling.
We got to show that on
the
show.
Yes, that is going to be. I'll make sure I get that together, and maybe it'll be our classic match of the week.
And from what I understand, next week I do have it on good authority from Michael Gratchner at WCPW. I'll be bringing in some Battle of the Belts footage from 2009.
That would be awesome.
That's going to be cool.
Yes, it will.
We'll be fun to have fun next week. The new on the mat, Richard T., Nicholas H., every week, week in and week out. It's kind of fun.
Yeah, we're doing it. You know,
we're doing
it. I mean,
we're gonna try Chris in here 1 week.
Oh, if I can
bring out Chris Hedford, your son.
No, we're gonna try. You know, but right now he's got a little squeeze on the side.
Oh, he does.
So well, maybe we can try to get her up in here also. So
very good.
But I tell you now, this next match is from Mid American Wrestling, Carmine DeSpirito and Company, from his last show in May of 2007, where it is the one and only Silas Young taking on very well known Milwaukee native. Dysfunction with special referee Austin Roberts.
Austin Roberts? I thought it was Austin Aries.
Austin Aries. See,
Austin Aries, Austin who was Aries. At the show this past week.
That's right, where him and Steve Boz had one of the match of the night.
Match of the night, yes. Steve Boz, Austin Aries. Right now we're going to this one, Silas Young taking on Dysfunction.
And like you said, this was from Mid-American, their last show that they put on. Which Carmine DeSpirito was even at the CAC convention.
Yes, he was. That guy's a shaker and a mover. NWA.
Oh, that's right. I tell you what, he was shaking and moving. The last night I seen him, I'm surprised he was able to sit up in his chair to play roulette.
Three sheets to the wind?
Oh, I'm like five sheets to the wind.
Yeah, there was some drunkenness going on at Cauliflower Alley.
Ah, yes, there was.
I don't know about that.
But here we go. Silas Young and Dysfunction getting ready to lock up here. Dysfunction with the takedown going into a leg bar.
Now, who's that referee? Any ideas?
Now, that is Austin Aries.
Oh, I thought he looked familiar. Well, I should have known. Here we go. Just kicks him off. Silas Young, no stranger to the mat wars. Now, what happened? Okay, we picked this stuff apart. Last week, we had a flyer here, or one of those internet sheets that said former WWE prospect, Silas Young. What? So he was down at Ohio Valley, or he was down in Florida?
He was down in Florida for a while, and from what I hear, just things, you know how WWE gets. They'll sign a whole bunch of new talent, and turn around 2 weeks later, they turn around and get rid of three-quarters of them.
Wow.
And Silas was on the block, you know.
But what an experience.
Yes. And I do know, just like Silas Young, Matt Longtime, Adrian Lynch, and all them guys, when WWE comes into Chicago or the Milwaukee area, these guys always have the dark matches.
Well, good.
Yes.
Good. It's nice to see up-and-coming Chicago talent. And look, speaking of up-and-coming Chicago talent, they're brawling all around Milwaukee. Here at MAW, baby, Silas Young taking it to Dysfunction. Now, Dysfunction, this guy's a Milwaukee original, eh?
That's right, which he is also the owner and promoter of the ICW, Insane Championship Wrestling, out there in Milwaukee.
Really?
Out there in Milwaukee, yes.
Good stuff. Now, Packerland Pro Wrestling, you ever get down that far, Nick?
No, I don't go as far as Green Bay.
Green Bay, that's pretty far. Yeah. They used to come down and wrestle for Windy City sometimes. A guy named Chris Bassett, who if you watch old AWA tapes, you'll see him wrestling people, you know, much like you'll see Sonny Rogers or you could see Sam DeCero. Chris Bassett was a former AWA guy, and he's got a school out there as well.
Oh, I see.
Yes, you do.
Well, I tell you now, also, too, you could always see Dysfunction on Great Lakes Championship Wrestling, Dave Hero and company. Silas has very good working relationships with Dave Hero, so it's, Dysfunction, real great guy. He runs a good promotion. The guys that he has on there are like guys from Bobby Valentino, the McCoy brothers, and Silas also gets on there. And he says every so often, Corp Robinson makes his way out there. So he says, Dysfunction and ICW, anytime you get out there, the Milwaukee people, check them out because you will definitely get your money's worth.
Silas Young caught up in the ropes, Dysfunction making his way down to punish him. Look at him, he's clapping his hands. Oh my goodness, what a punishing, crude thing to do to somebody. Got him right where he wants and taking advantage. Now just whips him down to the floor. Big elbow right in the face.
Another big forearm.
Yeah, just smashing him right in the
line.
Ouch. Face first to the side of that ring.
I tell you, Silas Young was always a staple of Carmine Espirito's Mid-America Wrestling. Just also as Ken Anderson, which you know has gone to WWE, as Ken Kennedy.
Oh,
that's right. So Ken Anderson was pretty much a real good staple in Mid-American's roster also with Rashi, the Skull Crusher, Rashi Brown.
Really?
Steve Stone, Hardcore Cray.
I did not know that.
Yes.
Mr. Kennedy comes from that group.
That's right.
How about that? I did not know that. That's a big dude.
Very big. I'd like to see him back on TV. I thought the Ken Kennedy thing with WWE was awesome.
You've been watching wrestling lately, Nick?
Here and there when I can.
Anything sticks out in your mind as entertaining, cool, takes you back, makes you know why you still love pro wrestling? Or do you think it's in a bad... We had Billy Wack in here week in, week out. All he'd say was bad, 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 bad. Anything exciting about pro wrestling for you this week?
I still think that the only thing that's still exciting about it is that the matches still seem to be solid. I wish the matches were a little longer or the matches meant a little more. To me, that the matches don't mean as much as they used to because you have all these people out here trying to script and write and stuff like that that are not wrestling personalities that don't know anything about wrestling.
So you think it's getting watered down a little bit?
I think so.
It's not the tight wrestling, hardcore, smash-mouth product me and you grew up with.
That's right.
I can kind of relate, and then again, I think we've grown in leaps and bounds, at least on TV, the stuff we watch. Sometimes TNA's got some cool angles and stuff, but my big thing is female wrestling right now I think's really good. Yeah. I like the Divas Division, WWE, and I like, TNA Knockouts. I get a big kick out of them. I love Awesome Kong, and I could watch her week in, week out.
Austin Kong was also, along with ODB, was at the CAC convention.
They were there. They wrestled on the show.
Yes.
Partying in the bar, eating with Billy Graham.
Yeah.
Good stuff. A weekend of wrestling history. Here we go. Silas Young trying to get back in this thing. Makes his way to his feet.
Looks like he's going to climb up to the top.
Dysfunction is prone, trying to stand back up. Austin Aries trying to keep an eye on this thing, your official. Slowly gets his way up there. Oh, snaps him back in. So that's coming in the hard way, Nick.
Yeah, it seemed like it could be very hard.
Look at those NWO shirts in the front row. Or is that BWO? Or is that like MAWO?
Yeah,
World Order.
I think it was BWO or something like that. I wasn't for sure. Adrian Serrano. It was the SWO.
SWO.
For Adrian Serrano that used to wrestle for Mid-American.
How about the NHWO? The Nicholas H. World Order?
I'd have to
look into
that. Ideas, I could run with that.
Yeah, you could.
I could run with that.
I think you could.
That's right.
I think you could really. I think you could. You know what? You should invade POW. With the Nicholas H. World Order.
We'll see what happens.
You could get Trevor Blanchard to take off his shirt and change his spots, and he'd have a shirt underneath that said, "I'm with the Nicholas H. New Wave Order." That's it, man. Yeah. That would be great. Well, yeah, yeah.
Well, see, here
or have a creature from the Black Lagoon in the middle of the ring, and he take off his mask, and it's Trevor Blanchard, but he still looks like the creature from the Black Lagoon. Sorry, did I miss the pin?
Well, no, actually, there was something like a pin, but Silas Young started to dispute it, so they're going to give them a couple more minutes.
Oh, good.
You know, they're going to give them a couple more minutes.
Let them battle on.
That's right, because I tell you, everybody put it on the line for Carmine this night.
Did they not?
This was a night for Carmine Despirito, and I want to say that I had a great opportunity to put something together for Carmine and past shows for him. You know, I've always enjoyed Carmine Despirito, and this is one of the promotions that I never had a chance to work, which I wish I would have.
I used to hear a lot about them back in the day. They had all kinds of hardcore stuff. They were using lots of light bulbs and glass for a while. Yeah. And I've never seen any of that footage. I just remember hearing Mae Young was coming there, and they did all kinds of crazy stuff with light bulbs and glass. And they were very extreme for a time.
Yes, very much so.
Yeah.
See now.
I'm gonna try and dig some of that footage. Oh, what's
see now here they double pinned each other with that roll up, so now they're disputing it again, and they're saying it's Austin Roberts' fault.
Austin Aries.
Austin Roberts must be talking about.
Well, there's
about
too many people named Austin in wrestling. Okay, let's just break it down, Nick. There's too many Austins. First name, last name. You know how many Hunters are there? Is there a bunch of different Hunters running around? No. There's one Hunter, there's one Triple H, okay? But now we got an Austin Aries, we got a Steve Austin, we got an Austin Roberts, we got too many, and then we got all the wrestlers naming their kids Hunter and Austin.
Oh, great.
That's getting tired, too. We need some new names. Stop. No more Austins.
Okay.
Sorry. Oh. What's he saying?
Well, he's pretty much asking the fans if they want 5 more minutes.
Oh, I want 5 more minutes. Hey!
Going in for a quick pin. Around and around they go. Austin Aries doesn't know who to start doing the pin on.
Yeah, that's a lot to follow there.
I don't know. I think I'd be getting dizzy.
Yeah, it looks like some sort of a Cudio. Some kind of, what's that game you used to play when you were a kid? Twister. Looks like some sort of a variation on Twister. Here we go. Wait, here he comes. They're both completely whacked out. Oh, my goodness.
But listen to the crowd. The crowd is actually applauding that. And they says Mid-American had some of the best fans.
Yeah.
You know, some of the best fans.
And I bet you used to hang out with them, hobnob, get to know them after the show.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Have a beer, smoke a Newport, right? Hang out. Why not? Have a little
fun. That's right. I tell you.
It's Milwaukee. What are you going to do if you can't have a beer in Milwaukee for the love of Pete? For the love of the Crusher Lisowski.
Yeah, right?
There you go. The man, the beer and the man that made Milwaukee famous. Uh-oh, Silas Young back up. Flings him in. Whoa, right into the corner. Gets a big boot in, though. Does Dysfunction. Dysfunction capitalizing.
Two.
Only a two. Austin Aries in there quicker than a hiccup. Now, what's that screen? Oh, that's like a screen, and it's got the logo behind them, right?
Okay. Yes.
And then there are 5 NWO fans that are in attendance. They ain't going nowhere. Wait a minute. Here he goes. Snaps him down. That had to hurt. Silas Young. Uh-oh, showing why he came to the dance. Springboard, oh my goodness. Gets him for the one, the two. Only a two.
Up again.
Only a two?
Yeah, only a two. Here's where Silas is getting into Austin's face. And I don't think, granted as much time Silas has had in, I don't think he'd want to make that mistake by trying to, you know, bump heads with Austin Aries. Reversal from the full Nelson. Another reversal. Brings the Dysfunction down to his knee here. I'm telling you, both of these guys went all out on this match.
Snaps him over, does Dysfunction. You can hear that crowd. They're a rumbling. Wait a minute. Now.
Back into the full Nelson again. I think they're kind of, both the guys are getting tired and they're kind of jockeying for position to get that, get set up for the pin.
Trying to wear the other man down as best they can.
Right.
Been a seesaw matchup thus far, but wait a minute. Looks like Dysfunction's a little bit worse for wear. Can't get his hand up 2 times. This could be it. The third try here. There's a little something left. There's a little something left. There's thunder in paradise.
You, brother.
Yeah. So how was he? Was he friendly? Did he come out and shake your hand?
Yeah, he was pretty nice. He hung out in the back for a little bit.
One, two, only a
See,
oh.
another double pin.
Oh, my
Both
goodness.
Guys pinned each other again.
Both men's shoulders were to the mat.
That's
for
right.
A one, two, three.
Yep. And they're going to start arguing with them again.
Oh, my goodness.
Because both guys kept pinning each other, and both of them want that victory. But Hogan was pretty cool. I mean, talked to him for about 10 minutes.
Really?
Yeah, which was a surprise to me, you know. I mean, granted, my son Chris got a little upset that, I met him and he didn't. So.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. What do we got here? Hey, went Silas Young on the mic. I don't know if we'll be able to make this out.
Yeah.
But you know what? We all know you're not an attitude problem. And the only reason you call it...
Boy, you must be reading the internet again, huh?
That sounds trouble.
My attitude problem, huh? All right, go ahead, finish.
There's quite a wrestling
you got
truck.
A problem
yes,
that you weren't asked to be a part of tonight. You know what? You're huh? such a big man, such a
not
big star. Why don't we just
see.
Make this a three-way?
Yeah.
The ref.
Yeah, I think they're trying to antagonize him into taking his shirt off and wrestling around for a few minutes.
So they want to make now they're going to have a three-way. Okay, now Austin Aries is going to get in on this thing, and both guys from behind. Oh.
Right, and they're pinning him, 1, 2, 3.
Well, how about that? But he wasn't even in the match. He was there. He was. Yeah. He's come here to ref tonight.
But I tell you what, Austin Aries, don't count the man out. You'll just see what kind of tricks he has up his sleeve.
He's raising your hands. Oh, how nice. What a show of sportsmanship. Ah, here he goes.
One.
That's what he wanted to see.
Oh, he just pinned Dysfunction.
Oh, now he's holding up Austin Aries' hand. Hey, man, from behind, gets them out. One, two.
And another three.
Another three count. Austin Aries pinned them both.
That's right.
Austin Aries pinned them both. He came. Wait, what's this guy got to say now? Okay, this one.
That's right, from
the wild man.
That's right.